Hello and welcome to NBC News. You are watching English Bulletin with me, Ratnakar. The news in detail. Janta curfew is enforced during this weekend as part of the administration's effort to keep the corona positive cases and casualties to as low as extent as possible. The decision regarding its implementation was taken in a recent meeting of people's representatives and NMC officials. Mayor Sandeep Joshi has appealed to people to stay indoors as far as possible and help the administration in containing the COVID-19 pandemic, and the people should exercise self-restraint and discipline in this situation. Except medical shops, most of the shops and commercial business establishments are closed during the curfew. Nagpur Chamber of Commerce and most of the business organizations have came out in support of the curfew, with senior NVCC office bearer saying that life and good health are first priorities and business can be done later. However, a few other business organizations have opposed it. A minor argument over pending liquor dues proved fatal for a Madurai-based man, as a hooch den owner reportedly killed him with sharp-edged weapons on Friday midnight. This is the second murder reported in the city within a span of 24 hours. According to police sources, the accused Golu Raut owned an illegal hooch den in Majri village under Yeshudara police station. The victim, Subodh Mishra, was his regular customer. However, Subodh would often enjoy liquor on the credit. This has resulted in a heavy unpaid dues, following which the duo would often pick up quarrel. Subodh on Friday night approached Golu's shop seeking liquor on credit. However, as Golu refused demanding money, the duo picked up a quarrel. The minor argument soon took ugly turn after Golu reportedly attacked Subodh with a sharp-edged weapon and killed him on the spot. The Nagpur bench of the Bombay High Court is hearing the issue of 64 recently designated dedicated COVID hospitals regarding their lacking the wherewithal to take the task of threatening the rising number of corona positive patients in the city. Recently, Mayor Sandeep Joshi had appealed to private hospitals to share the working of treating COVID-19 patients, as the government hospitals of Nagpur are feeling increasing stress as far as handling this crisis is concerned. Consequently, as many as 102 private hospitals of the city have been recently designated as a dedicated COVID hospitals. However, medical experts are of the opinion that of these, only 38 hospitals have the expert medical staff and equipment necessary to treat corona positive patients, and representatives from 64 hospitals have approached the High Court in this regard. A 5-member judicial committee is assessing the matter and shall announce its verdict soon. A protest demonstration was recently conducted by BJP leader and office bearer in the city over the issue of the MVA government providing insufficient compensation for flood victims and especially farmers during the recent flood, which devastated many parts of Vidarbha and inflicted huge losses on people already reeling under the adverse financial repercussion on the COVID-19 pandemic-induced lockdown. The demonstration was carried out in many parts of the city and was spearheaded by leader like former Energy Minister Chandrasekhar Bavankule, MLA Girish Vyas and MLA Samir Mege. A significant number of BJP office bearers and activists too were present, and slogans were shouted against the perceived injustice and urging the government to wake up from its slumber. The damage due to the flood is estimated to be several hundred of crores, so the rupees 16 crores compensation by the government is a pittance, BJP office bearer said. Well, that's all from this bulletin. For more updates in and around the city, stay tuned with NBC News. Till then, Ratnakar says goodbye. Please take good care of yourself.